short skit today, and it's based on this book called 'Twas the Night Before Thanksgiving, and the kids have done a fabulous job. We've talked a lot about trying to speak up so everyone can hear them. I know we're a little nervous, we have some jitters, but you're gonna do a great job, first graders. Okay, my front row kneel. My back row stand. My blocking room.
'Twas the day before Thanksgiving, and all through the trees, the fall leaves were spinning aloft in the breeze. Eight children had boarded their school bus with grins, in hopes that a field trip soon would begin.
Sailed on through the new fallen leaves.
When out on the road, there rose such a clatter, they threw down their windows to see what was the matter.
When, what with their wondering eyes, should they see but a miniature farm and eight tiny turkeys?
And a little old man, so lively and rugged, they knew in a moment it was Farmer McNugget.
He was dressed all in denim from his head to his toe, with a pinch of polyester and a dash of Velcro.
And then in the twinkling they heard in the straw, each prancing and pawing of each little claw.
Mole rabbit and chicken, his cockles they came. He whistled and shouted and called them by name.
Now Ollie, now Stanley, now Larry and Mo, on Wally, on Beaver, on Chimp and Grock Joe.
The turkeys were chunky with smiling pink faces. They greeted the children with gummy embraces.
So after the barnyard they ran and they flew. They got them and gave them like friends sometimes.
Then someone spotted it and asked why they are. Then she asked Farmer Nugget what it was for.
With a blink of his eye and a twist of his head, the old farmer told a grim tale of dread.
"Tonight," said McNugget, "these feathery beasts will be chopped up and roasted for Thanksgiving feast."
"Oh dear," cried McNugget, "now what should I do?" So he dashed to the well, and the teacher went to them.
And they fetched some water fresh from the ground, hoping a swig might calm everyone down.
When they returned, the quiet, the matter, the children were calm and mysteriously saddened.
Reagan, do you want me to do your lines with you, sweet pea? Those first grade jitters, they get you. That's good, Max. You just perfect.
I went to the school bus all hopping and hopping. It's not easy to walk or talk when you're stuck.
Then as the school bus drove off into the night, McNugget looked around, not a turkey in sight.
"'Twas the night before Thanksgiving. The stars up above shine down on his school bus. Around he went blue.
The very next evening, a family of bliss with a fluffy Thanksgiving turkey as guest."
Romeo, Afro-Stan.
They feasted on.